Small ship cruising really is a unique experience. Who better to explain what life on board is really like than cruise director Neil Horrocks?
We've only 100 passengers. Everyone gets to know each other, but not too well. So you can have your own space, you can join in with anything you want to join in with, and it really is what you want it to be.
And it's all about conversation, isn't it? It's very sociable. Everyone's talking to each other, to the staff, to the crew.
But as the cruise develops, the atmosphere enhances on board, and by the end of the cruise, up in the club before dinner, it's a wonderful, lively, social scene, and after dinner as well. And it makes for a fantastic atmosphere.
And once we go ashore, talk me through the different options of shore excursions and how that's planned.
We always have an included excursion in every port, sometimes more than one where the passengers can choose. And I get the agents badgering me, saying to me, how many tickets have you sold for the excursion? And it's a joy to turn around to them and just tell them how many passengers we have and that we have to provide for everybody because it's all included. And we always also try and be creative because we don't want just to go to a port and do like some ships do where they just have a panoramic trip and it's the cheapest option is the included one and that's it. We try and always be creative, try and think of new ideas because many passengers are so well travelled, they've been to these places before. They want to see something different, but they want to see it in style and in comfort, and it works really well.
Lectures are also a key part of the daily programme. On this cruise, Professor Barry Cunliffe was one of two lecturers on board.
For a lot of my life, I was the Professor of European Archaeology at Oxford, and I've been invited on this cruise to give a series of talks to help the passengers understand some of the places they're going to and the broader historical context.
And clearly your lectures are going down very well. You always seem to have a crowd of people around you asking questions. How have you found it, being aboard?
Oh, it's fantastic. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. There's a huge amount of expertise on board, people who come from all walks of life, and they can feed into the discussion and the questions.
Whether going ashore or on board, with 70 crew looking after a maximum of 118 passengers, the level of service and interaction with staff is very high.
They create a nice atmosphere, they have a gentle touch, they interact with us all the time, not just when they're supposed to be doing, but they're just great fun.
Absolutely delightful. Really lovely, aren't they?
And they work so hard.
The trouble is, it is Jill and I.
Yes, I'm princess and Mum's queen.
The man who takes the most credit probably is Neil, and I think he deserves it.
He does, definitely.
And the worst thing, really, I was talking to other passengers, that he'd be a very difficult man to complain to if things went wrong, because he's such a nice chap. And a good line in ad libs and stories.
And you know when you should leave something.